Welcome to all of you. Today's our discussion topic is switched mode power supply. Switched mode power supply is based on the chopper principle. The DC voltage is controlled by using the duty cycle of chopper by PWM or FM techniques. The circuit configuration used for SMPS can be classified into four broad categories, which are namely flyback converter, push-pull converter, half bridge converter, and last one is the full bridge converter. Okay. In SMPS circuit discussed here, PWM technique is used for the inverter. The output of the inverter is then converted into the DC by using a simple diode rectifier. As inverter is made to operate at very high frequency, the ripples are obtained in the DC output voltage, and that can be filtered out by using the small filter components. If the switching devices are power transistors, the chopping frequency is limited to 40 kHz, and if the switching devices are power MOSFETs, then the chopping frequency is of the order of 200 kHz. At such high frequencies, the ferrite power transformers are used in the SMPS. Okay, now we are going to discuss the four categories of SMPS. Okay, the first category is nothing but the flyback converter. Figure here shows the flyback converter. It consists of a power MOSFET M1, the transformer for the isolation purpose, the diode D, the capacitor C, and the load. Okay, the uncontrolled rectifier used here, okay, converts the AC into DC, and this DC voltage is then fed to the flyback converter. Okay, now when power MOSFET is turned on here, okay, here that power MOSFET is turned on means it will act like a closed switch. Okay, the supply voltage VS gets applied to the transformer primary. Okay, and the equivalent circuit is as shown in the figure here. Okay, see M1 is a closed switch and the supply voltage VS gets applied across the transformer primary. So now V1 is equivalent to applied voltage VS. Okay, now the corresponding voltage V2 is induced in the transformer secondary winding, okay, as shown with the polarities, okay, here minus in the plus. Okay, so V2 becomes equivalent to VS divided by N1 into N2. Okay, now as V2 reverse biases the diode D, equivalent circuit obtained here as shown in the figure. Okay, diode D gets reverse biased due to the induced voltage V2. The filter capacitor is assumed to be large enough so that the output voltage is equivalent to the capacitor voltage. So VCT is equivalent to V0 here. When M1 is turned off, okay, the voltage of opposite polarity gets induced in the primary as well as in the secondary winding as shown in the figure. Okay, now here M1 is turned off, okay, so that the polarities across the primary winding as well as secondary windings gets reversed, and due to this, okay, now V1 is equivalent to minus Vs, and so that V2 becomes equivalent to minus V0, which is equal to minus Vs divided by N1 into N2. Okay, due to this secondary voltage V2, okay, here the diode D becomes forward biased and the current ID starts flowing through the diode. Okay, as a result, the energy stored in the transformer core is delivered partly to the load and partly it is used to charge the capacitor C. Okay, now during the time T1, when the power MOSFET is in on condition, then V1 is equal to Vs and V2 is equivalent to Vs divided by N1 into N2. For magnetizing current IM, it is assumed that the transformer core, okay, it is not demagnetized completely at the end of the periodic time, which is given by T is equivalent to T on plus T off. Okay, so IM at T is equivalent to 0 is not, see here, these are the waveforms, respective waveforms. So at T is equivalent to 0, IM is not equivalent to 0 because it is assumed that the magnetizing current IM is not demagnetized, or the transformer core is not demagnetized completely at the end of the periodic time. Okay, so here some voltage will be there, which is referred as IM0. Okay, so during time turn on time, that is during time t on, okay, IM rises linearly from its initial value IM0 to the final value IM1 at t is equivalent to t on. With rise of IM during t on, the magnetic energy gets stored in the transformer core. Okay, and this variation in IM is given as IM at time t is equivalent to IM0, which is the initial current, plus Vs divided by L into t. Okay, where t varies from 0 to t on. Okay, and L is nothing but the transformer magnetizing inductance. Okay, given in Henry's, the unit is Henry. Okay, at time t is equivalent to t on, the current IM at turn on time t on is given as maximum, its maximum value IM1, which is equivalent to now IM0 plus Vs divided by L into t on. When M1 is turned off, the EMF induced in the primary and secondary winding gets reversed, as shown in the figure, so that the diode D is now forward biased and the current in transformer secondary winding begins to flow through the diode D. Okay, as this current ID is reduced from IM1 to IM0 here. Okay, see here, this reduces from IM1 to IM0. Okay, at time instant T is equivalent to T, the transformer core energy is now delivered to the load. Okay, so during this turn off time, okay, at this instant t off, t is equivalent to t off, okay, here V2 is equivalent to minus V0. So that voltage in the primary is referred as V1 is equivalent to minus V0 divided by N2 into V1. Okay, see here, okay, during this time period when the M1 is in off condition, okay, V1 is given as minus V0 divided by N1 into, minus V0 divided by N2 into N1. The fall in the current IM during this turn off period or T off period can be expressed by IM at time instant T is equivalent to IM1 minus V0 divided by N2 into N1 into 1 upon L multiplied by T minus T on, which is nothing but T off. Okay, during the period T on to T. Okay, so here now at time instant T is equivalent to T, the current IM is given as IM at T is equal to IM1, which is the final value, initial value, minus V0 divided by N2 into N1 multiplied by 1 upon L T minus T on. Okay, substituting now the value of IM1 here, okay, which is given by this equation, we have IM at T is equivalent to IM0 plus Vs divided by L into T on minus V0 divided by N2 into N1 multiplied by 1 by L into T minus T on. Okay, since the net energy stored in the core over the periodic time T is 0, IM0 is equivalent to IM at time instant T. Okay, so IM0 will become equivalent to IM0 plus Vs divided by L into T on minus V naught divided by V2 into N1 multiplied by 1 upon L to T minus T on. Okay, so by solving this or simplifying this, we have Vs into T on is equivalent to V naught divided by A into T minus T on, where A is nothing but the turns ratio. A is equivalent to N2 divided by N1, which is equal to turns ratio. Okay, so again simplifying further, we have load voltage V out is equal to V out is equal to A into Vs into T on divided by T minus T on, which is equal to A into Vs into K divided by 1 minus K, where K is equivalent to duty cycle, which is equal to T on divided by T. The open circuit voltage across the M1 when it is in off condition is given as VOC is equal to V1 plus Vs, which is equal to V out divided by N2 into N1, okay, which is nothing but V1, okay, plus Vs. So it will become V naught divided by A plus Vs, where A is nothing but the turns ratio. Okay, so open circuit voltage is given by replace the value of output voltage. So Vs into K divided by 1 minus K plus Vs. So by simplifying this, we have Vs divided by 1 minus K. So open circuit voltage VOC is given as source voltage divided by 1 minus duty cycle. Okay, the diode current ID is given as ID at time instant T is equal to IMT multiplied by N1 divided by N2. Replace the value of IMT here. So N1 divided by N2 multiplied by IM1 minus V0 divided by N2 into N1 1 upon L into T minus T on. Okay, so here by simplifying this, we have ID or T is equal to IM1 divided by A minus V out divided by A square into L multiplied by T minus T on. The flyback converters offers the simple SMPS and is useful in the application below the 500 watt. Okay, these are used in the applications which are below 500 watt. Okay, so this is the flyback converter. Okay, now comes the push-pull converter. Okay, the circuit diagram of push-pull converter is as shown in the figure. Okay, it uses two power MOSFETs M1 and M2, okay, and a transformer with mid taps in both the primary as well as secondary winding. An uncontrolled rectifier is used to convert AC into DC, which is fed to this push-pull SMPS. The inductor L and capacitor C are used as the filter components, okay, and the load is used at the output. When M1 is turned on, okay, the voltage Vs here, this voltage is equivalent to Vs. This voltage Vs gets applied, okay, in the lower half of the transformer winding. Okay, so here in the lower half of the transformer primary, the voltage Vs gets applied, okay, when M1 is turned on. So here this voltage becomes V1 is equivalent to Vs. As a result, the voltage V2, okay, in the upper half of the secondary as well as in the lower half of the secondary winding gets induced. This voltage V2 forward biases okay, this voltage V2, which is in the upper half of the secondary winding, forward biases the diode D1, and this voltage V2 reverse biases D2. Okay, therefore the load voltage Vout is given as Vout is equivalent to Vs divided by N1 into N2, which is equivalent to A into Vs. Okay, when M2 gets turned on, then V1 becomes equivalent to minus Vs. Okay, and this is applied to the upper half of the primary winding. Okay, so V2 now is equivalent to this. Oh, here when M2 is here, M1 is in on condition. When M2 is in on condition, okay, V1 becomes equivalent to minus Vs. Okay, as M2 is in on condition, okay, this voltage gets, or this reverse voltage gets applied to the upper half of the transformer primary winding, so that now V2 here becomes equivalent to minus Vs divided by N1 into N2. Okay, so this voltage V2 induced in the transformer secondary winding, okay, it reverse biases the forward biases the diode D2 while reverse biases the diode D1. So that now output voltage is equivalent to A into Vs, which is equal to minus Vs divided by N1 into N2. Okay, so Vout is equivalent to minus Vs divided by N1 into N2. Okay, so this shows that the voltage on primary swings from plus Vs with M1 on to the minus Vs with M2 on. The power MOSFET M1 and M2 operate with the duty cycle of 0.5. Okay, so here the duty cycle K is equivalent to 0.5. When M1 is off, the voltage across M1 terminals is VOC is equivalent to 2 times Vs. Okay, and at the same, in the same manner, when M2 is in off condition, the voltage across M1 is equivalent to open circuit voltage VOC is equivalent to 2 times Vs. Okay, as both M1 and M2 are subjected to open circuit voltage of 2 times Vs, this configuration is used only for low voltage applications. Okay, so this is all about the push-pull converter. Now comes the half bridge converter. Okay, so circuit diagram shown here is for half bridge converter. Okay, so this configuration consists of, okay, the uncontrolled rectifier, the two capacitors C1 and C2, okay, the two power MOSFETs M1 and M2, the transformer with mid-tap at the secondary side, the two diodes D1 and D2, and the filter components L and C. The two capacitors C1 and C2 have equal capacitances, so that the voltage across each of these two is equivalent to Vs divided by 2. When M1 gets turned on, the voltage across this capacitor C1 appears across the transformer primary, so that here V1 becomes equivalent to Vs divided by 2, which is equal to VC1. Okay, so that the voltage induced in the secondary winding is this V2 is equivalent to plus Vs divided by 2 times N1 into N2. As V1 is equal to Vs divided by 2, V2 becomes Vs divided by 2 times N1 into N2. Diode D1 now gets forward biased while diode D2 is reverse biased. Okay, when M2 is, and so that the output voltage is now equivalent to V2. Okay, so now when M2 is turned on, the reverse voltage of the capacitor C2 is applied across the transformer primary winding. Okay, so this voltage, which is across capacitor C2, okay, it gets applied to the transformer primary winding. So now V1 becomes equivalent to minus Vs divided by 2. Okay, and so that the voltage induced in the secondary winding is V2 is equal to minus Vs divided by 2 times N1 into N2. Now the diode D2 gets forward biased while diode D1 is reverse biased. Okay, so that the transformer primary gets swings from minus Vs divided by 2 to plus Vs divided by 2. And so that the average output voltage is given as V out is equivalent to Vs divided by 2 times N1 into N2. So output voltage is equivalent to 0.5 into A, the distance ratio, multiplied by Vs. Okay, when M1 is in off condition, the open circuit voltage across M1 terminals is VOC is equivalent to Vs. Okay, in the same manner, M2, when M2 is in off condition, then open circuit voltage across M2 is given as VOC is equivalent to Vs. Okay, so for high voltage DC applications, half bridge converter is preferred over the push pull converter. Okay, now comes the full bridge input. Okay, now comes the full bridge converter here. Okay, figure here shows the full bridge converter. It consists of the uncontrolled rectifier. Okay, the four MOSFETs M1, M2, M3 and M4. Okay, the transformer with mid-tap at the secondary windings, the two diodes D1 and D2, the filter components L and C and the load. Okay, the function of the control circuit is to sense the output voltage and to decide about the duty cycle of the four MOSFETs. Okay, when M1 and M2 gets turned on together, the voltage Vs is applied in across the transformer primary winding so that V1 is equivalent to Vs here. Okay, and the secondary voltage is now V2 is equal to Vs divided by N1 multiplied by N2, which is equal to A into Vs. Okay, now the diode D1 becomes forward biased, and so that output voltage is equivalent to A into Vs, which is equal to V2. Okay, now when M3 and M4 gets turned on together, the primary voltage gets reversed, and so that now V1 becomes equivalent to minus Vs. Okay, and so that V2 is equivalent to minus Vs divided by N1 into N2, which is equivalent to minus A into Vs. Okay, now the diode D2 gets forward biased, and the output voltage is again equivalent to V out is equal to A into Vs. Okay, so the open circuit voltage across each MOSFET is VOC is equivalent to Vs here. Okay, so out of all the four configurations of SMPS, the full bridge converter with minimum voltage and current stress on the will provide the minimum voltage and current stress on the power MOSFET. And it is therefore very powerful or popular in high power applications above the 750 watt. Okay, it is used in the applications above 750 watt. Okay, the overall size of the SMPS depends upon the operating frequency of the SMPS. Okay, now there are various advantages of the SMPS. The main advantage of SMPS over the conventional linear power supply is, okay, for the same power ratings, SMPS is of smaller size, lighter in weight, and possesses high efficiency because of its high frequency operation. Okay, SMPS is less sensitive to input voltage variation. Okay, so as there are some advantages, there are some disadvantages also for SMPS. The SMPS has higher output ripple and its regulation is very worse. The SMPS is a source of both electromagnetic and radio interference due to high frequency switching. Okay, and also control of radio frequency noise requires to be used of filters on both input as well as at the output side of the SMPS. Okay, as the advantages of SMPS are very outweigh their shortcomings, so that the SMPS is very popular in among the applications or various applications. Okay, so this is all about the switched mode power supply and the all four configurations of switched mode power supply. Okay, so I hope this is very useful information for or regarding the SNPS. Okay, thank you very much.